Hello students, welcome back to your English class. Today's class is on writing skills and today we will learn paragraph writing. Hello, I am Mrs. Janisha, your English teacher. What is a paragraph? Paragraph can be called as a group of sentences that introduces, presents, and develops one main idea about the topic. And it can be divided into three major parts. Now, the word paragraph comes from two Greek words, para, which means besides, and graph, which means write. That means, technically, paragraph means to write besides or near. A paragraph can also be called as a group of sentences which are organized around a central topic. They are a series of sentences that are organized and coherent, and they are all related to a single topic. A paragraph is a self-contained unit of a conversation in writing which deals with a particular point or idea or topic. And the cardinal or the thumb rule of a paragraph is to write on one topic. The writing should focus on one idea only. So now we will learn how to write a paragraph. In April, we had already introduced paragraph writing to you. The structure of a paragraph. The basic structure of a paragraph usually consists of 5 to 7 sentences. The first sentence is a topic sentence. Then you need minimum three supporting sentences. You can also have more supporting sentences. But when you say three supporting sentences, that means it should have 3 different points that are supporting your topic sentence. And at the end, you can have 1 to 2 concluding sentences. I repeat, there are normally, the structure of a paragraph is divided into 3 parts: topic sentence, supporting sentence, and concluding sentence. A paragraph is a group of sentences that will express a complete thought. And it is usually 5 to 7 sentences, but it can also be longer. Now, what is the topic sentence? Topic sentence, this is the main idea of this paragraph. It is the first sentence of the paragraph and it is the main idea. It conveys the overall point of this paragraph, that what is this paragraph about? So what is the use of it? It helps the writer focus on the idea that they have to write about. And it helps the reader know what the paragraph is about. Now, the second part of the paragraph writing was the supporting details. Now, supporting details, these are the sentences that are used to support the main idea, which is stated in the topic sentence. So they give more information about the main idea, but they give this more information through various examples. Okay, so they say in detail what the topic sentence is already saying. There should be clear evidence. Clear meaning you should clearly state the supporting evidence. Why is your topic sentence your idea? So it should be clear evidence that says what the topic sentence is already saying and why the topic sentence is trustworthy. So you have to support it. I'm going to give you all examples later on. So we will talk about this that time. The supporting details should be strong enough and convincing so that the readers will rely upon the topic sentence. Your supporting details are very, very important. And finally, the last part is the concluding sentence. Now, concluding sentence is a reflection of the main idea pronounced in the topic sentence. This sums up what the topic sentence and the supporting details talk about. Now, this is the closing sentence. So this should remind the reader what your topic sentence was and how true it was. So it is compulsory for the completion of the paragraph unity. The concluding sentence is compulsory. It eventually indicates the end of the paragraph, and in case there is a next paragraph, it will also prepare reader for a smooth transition between the two paragraphs. Now, so the concluding sentence, it sums up the main point of the paragraph, and the concluding sentence should not, I repeat, should not introduce a new point. So these were the three parts of the paragraph. Now, first, let us understand the difference between a good paragraph and a bad paragraph. Let's look at these two paragraphs. Paragraph number one. My mother is a very busy person. My toy car is broken. The cows are grazing in the fields. The sun sets in the west. We live in Dhankota. My name is Kali Prasad. A mouse is a little creature. Now let's look at paragraph number two. There's a number mistake over there. My mother is a very busy person. She works 16 hours a day. She goes to office early in the morning and comes back quite late at night. Sometimes she even works on Saturdays. She has no time to play or she has no time for play or fun. So these were the two paragraphs. Now, which according to you is a better paragraph and why? I want you to think about this for the next 1 minute. Have you all thought about it? Do you think paragraph number one is a good paragraph? No. And that is because all the sentences are not focusing on one central topic. If you look at it, it's not even in a correct order. And the sentences don't flow into each other. If you look at the second paragraph, you can, and I asked you, what is the central idea of the paragraph? You can tell me that the mother is a very busy person. If you look at the next lines, there's a clear evidence given why she's a very busy person. Because number one, she works 16 hours a day. Number two, she goes to office early in the morning and she comes back quite late at night. And number three, she even works on Saturdays. So these were the three supporting lines, the three supporting evidences, which clearly state why the mother is a very busy person, which was the topic sentence. And finally, she has written a concluding sentence, that is, she has no time for play or fun. So this was a conclusion, a reflection. So in these two paragraphs, you can clearly see paragraph number two is more organized. It is following all the rules of paragraph writing, whereas paragraph one has distorted ideas. They are in a random fashion, and it is not even good for a reader to read. Even when you must have read it, you must have found your thoughts wavering around and not focusing on one thing. So now look at this paragraph over here. We have highlighted the different parts of the paragraph. The first sentence is the topic sentence. Then everything in the light blue color is the supporting sentence. And finally, we have a concluding sentence. Please read this paragraph in your mind and let me know if, because we will discuss this in a class later on Zoom class, if the supporting evidence did support the topic sentence. Okay, now let's check our understanding of how much we have learned. Over here, what do you think the highlighted line is? Trees are useful to us. They clean the air around us. On a hot day, they give us shade. We can use their wood to build our homes. Trees also help to keep the environment fresh. They provide us oxygen. I want you to sit with a rough book and write down the answers. What do you think the highlighted line in this paragraph, which part of the paragraph is it? Trees are useful to us. Okay, I'm giving the answer now. The answer is the topic sentence. Anytime during the video you feel the teacher is rushing, please pause, finish your work and continue. Next one, please sit with your notebooks and write your rough books and write this answer over there. Pokhara is an amazing place to visit. First, it is a place known for its scenic beauty. Also, Pokhara offers a range of adventure activities for the visitors. In addition, you get to visit exotic places within the city. These features make Pokhara a truly amazing place, well worth a visit. What do you think the highlighted lines over here are? The highlighted lines over here are the supporting sentences or the supporting details. They are all supporting the topic line that Pokhara is an amazing place to visit. And then we have the reasons that it is known for scenic beauty. It offers a range of adventure activities. You also get to visit exotic places within the city. These are the three supporting evidences that are backing up or that are explaining in detail the topic sentence. And finally, you have these features make Pokhara a truly amazing place, well worth a visit. All right, over here, what do you think the highlighted line is? I admire my friend Ken because he doesn't give up. When Ken wanted to enter a good university, he studied hard to pass the examination. The first time he took the exam, he did not do well and he felt very discouraged. But he knew he wanted to study at the university, so he studied more. The next year, he tried taking the exam again. The second time, he did very well. And now he is studying engineering. I believe Ken is a good role model for me, and he has taught me that never giving up is the best way to succeed. What do you think these highlighted lines are in this paragraph? Please write down in your rough books. Correct. These are the concluding sentences, which are concluding the main topic. The first topic sentence is, I admire my Ken because he doesn't give up. And the last sentence, I believe Ken is a good role model for me and he has taught me that never giving up is the best way to succeed. They both reflect on each other. Now, this is another, please write down the correct answer in your rough books. You have to select the correct topic sentence for the paragraph. She works 6 hours a day. She goes to office early in the morning, comes back quite late at night. Sometimes she even works on Saturdays. She doesn't have much free time at all. This is a very interesting paragraph. We've just read a similar one, so you should not find difficulty selecting the appropriate topic sentence. The answer is, Mrs. Lama is a very busy person. Why will we not select the first one, that Mrs. Lama is a good housewife? Because the supporting evidences and the concluding sentence are not talking about her being a good housewife. They are talking about her being busy. Okay, so that was the central idea of this paragraph, that Mrs. Lama is a very busy person. Okay, now this I want you to do in your notebooks. This is like I've given you incomplete sentences. I want you to complete it. So this is your notebook work. You will finish this in your notebooks. The first line will be paragraph writing, guided writing. Paragraph writing, guided writing. Leave two lines and then write, my favorite city is, write a name of the city that you like. Then you will write, this city is located in the state of, write the name of the state. I would prefer you write an Indian city and an Indian state, but in case you want to write some other city in some other state, yes, you can. There is no compulsion. This is just my preference. Okay, so for example, my favorite city is Jaipur. The city is located in the state of Rajasthan. I like this city because, and you will give the first reason why you like that city. Then you will say, one of my favorite things to do in this city is, and you will mention something you like to do. And lastly, you will say, another thing I enjoy in the name of the city is, and you will write that. And over here, the final sentence is not mentioned. I have left it on to you how you will conclude it. You will not write that Jaipur is my favorite city in the world. No, you will write some interesting concluding sentence, which we will discuss in your Zoom class. This is a guided practice for writing your paragraph. All these fill in the blanks have to be filled by you. I am not giving you a fixed number of words, like 3 words or 4 words. You can finish that sentence in any way you like. While you are doing this sentence, you must remember the entire paragraph is on one topic. The topic sentence, you always start a paragraph with a topic sentence. Supporting sentence should support the main idea. Okay, and you should have evidences in them. Please use vivid words, that is descriptive words and adjectives, to make your paragraph very interesting. Follow a logical order and flow of sentences. I've already done that for you. And all sentences should begin in a different manner. Like you can see over here, the first one is my favorite city is, then this city is located where, I like the city because, one of my favorite things to do in the city is, already there. Another thing that I enjoy in Jaipur is whatever, but I want you all to write one more line over there to make it more concluding. If you will not write that line, it's fine. We will help you during your Zoom class. But right now I want you to finish this work in your notebooks. With these children, we have come to the end of our class. And to know how much you understood from my video lesson, I have made a form which is there in the description box below. Right below this, there must be a description box. Please go there and fill that form up. And it's a self-correcting form. You are not going to get any marks or grade for this form. This form is just for you to understand if you understood the topic correctly or not. Okay? So please do that. With this, we have come to the end of our class. Thank you, students. Stay home. Stay safe. Take care. Keep learning. Thank you.